What's happening? What's happening? It's your boy Lewis Belt.
Teddy Ray, we out here in the Cali Kickback. We in the building.
We
in
outside.
The house, in the studio apartment, in the motherfucking three bedroom townhouse, nigga.
The dungeon.
Double garage, whatever you sitting on. I'm just shouting out whatever they at.
We on the bed.
Everywhere.
Grab some ass while you watching this.
In the car, on your phone, toilet at work.
Rolling up.
I'm out of.
You know what I'm saying?
Wherever you may be. Some standing up.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you might be rolling up, standing up.
Eating some cereal. Oh, you know. Niggas love watching shit eating cereal.
Man.
That's the play.
And we refuse to plus pray until they really get that first little.
Till you dip your spoon.
Till you stab it.
Yeah.
I press play. All right. Found what I needed to watch.
Oh, my mama.
What's up, man? This is Cali Kickback. We got a special guest in the building. Y'all don't know this man. Y'all will know this man. This man is.
Oh, talk your shit, Spence.
They probably do, bro. It's, you know what I'm saying? It don't look like it on IG, but I'm in the streets.
Oh,
that's
shit,
where I met
Spence.
This man at, in the streets. Bro.
Me too.
Outside. That's ironic.
That nigga is outside. He got a point. He knows the angle.
Street baby.
From the streets to the strip clubs and all over the world, man. My nigga.
Niggas don't know where I live at.
Spence and Neal, straight out of the ATL, man.
What's happening, man? Appreciate y'all for having me, man. Kicking it with y'all folks. Can't wait to smoke some weed, talk some shit with y'all niggas.
What you smoking on?
Oh, mama.
You bought that from the A?
Yeah, this is Dutch. I carried this all the way through the airport.
Oh, yeah, you know that's from the A. He got a, that's a Swisher, right?
It's a Dutch.
Dutch,
it's
flat as fuck. Nigga, that shit done been on three.
Nah, I put it in my belt line.
Connecting flights.
That motherfucker dropped right here.
He had to stop in Dallas every day before I got to Cali.
It made it, though.
Oh, my mama.
It's good to let a weed right there. I ain't bought no weed since I've been out here. But y'all got
for
two.
Real?
Y'all got an abundance of weed out here. Like, niggas just be giving weed away. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I was with this little hoe in Oakland before I came to L.A. She was like, you know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna see you for a minute. You know what I'm saying? Take your little weed.
A little weed be like a handful, seven. A handful.
Y'all know y'all got strippers in Atlanta, nigga. We got weed, nigga.
Yeah, okay.
That's our culture, nigga. Just weed.
That's a good. I trade off because I don't really fuck strippers like that.
In Texas, they got weed and strippers, and they come together, and the strippers.
You think Texas got more weed than Atlanta? I don't know. Niggas, that's where niggas.
I'm just talking about my Texas experience.
Oh, okay. Well. Weed everywhere where California niggas go.
Niggas was smoking at church. I had went Sunday when I got here. Niggas was in the pool pit firing up and shit. So.
You know what's crazy? I remember my drummer. Soon as he was done, like when the pastor would start preaching, because he only need to come at the tail end of the sermon when it's time.
Yeah.
So he taking weed breaks.
Yeah, he take a weed break. Every top of that sermon. He outside by the palm tree on the side, far end of the church, watching the front.
They really just need to make weed legal everywhere.
It's getting there.
Especially at this point.
But it get tough.
It's still not legal?
Hell no, bro. You'll go to jail for anything.
All the weed I done smoked in front of the police out there.
You didn't do it in front of police.
You
either that, or
the
they just
police.
Didn't feel like taking you to jail for some other reason. But
I felt like that's what it be.
They had to. They didn't feel like.
Or I might be in just situations where it's just.
It's weed is because it is certain spots where weed is acceptable in Atlanta if you like around the right celebrity or something. You know, you're famous and shit. So
yeah,
you know
I be thinking,
but I wouldn't try that shit as a regular nigga.
As a regular nigga,
yeah. Like I'm not.
I know I'm not
here.
To go around Georgia smoking. No, that's what
that's
I do.
Definitely,
yeah,
that's definitely.
Okay. That's
nah,
a difference.
Yeah,
that Brittany Griner your ass.
Yeah,
see you in the restaurant or some shit like that.
Man,
don't play with it.
Free
ass, right?
Brittany Griner. I heard they about to swap her for. A real terrorist.
What you heard? I heard she getting 10 to the dog.
She getting
10? But that's what my daddy be saying. Oh, that nigga don't know shit.
Damn.
my daddy was like,
daddy
you like
be predicting niggas' cases?
He was like, you like WNBA? Well, you ain't gonna never see Brittany Crowder again. I was like, nigga.
Damn.
Nigga, she had a vape.
She probably knocking hoes up in there, though.
It ain't the hoes she want.
That hoe ready to get home. Let me say, Ashtray.
Why you say that?
That hoe ready
she
to get
used
home.
To ass and all kind of titties and
yeah, she don't
Brittany Crowder up in the Magic City and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, she
like,
done fuck with some bad bitches now.
Yeah,
she don't wanna fuck with no Russian criminal.
Like, you don't know who in them little Russian hoes might be killing there. You don't know.
Not in Russia.
They don't
lock up bad hoes in Russia. Them hoes get sold.
That's why she ain't looked happy. Not one day they didn't have her.
And she ain't. I don't know if you noticed all the pictures she got on the same fit. So like she been wearing that shit since the game.
For real.
This bitch is she itchy as fuck.
I ain't seen her.
Oh yeah, I seen her. She still got the same hoodie and shit.
Like, yeah, hoodie. She be taking the hoodie and the shirt off. making it seem like it's, you know, different days.
Mm-hmm. Damn. I feel bad for Shawty though, for real.
I really do.
Yeah, that's janky.
Because don't nobody want to go to a foreign jail.
A foreign jail.
Yeah, that's
bro.
Crucial.
Jail you don't want to go to jail. Yeah, jail period.
But it's probably a whole nother level out the country for sure.
I don't know though. I went to jail in Clayton County, so it may be the same thing.
Who they, probably got the smartest jail? They like these other countries. I heard Mexico shit janky.
I don't want to go no jail with no sofa agreement. Like that's the only problem with her right now. Them the jails where you can't get niggas back from. Like the U.S. ain't got no agreement with them niggas. That's why she stuck over there. Like if it was any, if it was anywhere else, like Mexico, America come get your ass.
Right.
But she over there with some niggas that we don't fuck with. Well, actually, we fucked with them too hard, so we got dang. We
yeah, Mexico be money hungry too. Yeah, so you can get them niggas about
30 pesos. And you home?
Yeah, you go. You can go.
You home, nigga? Off 30 pesos.
Oh, my mom, you get them niggas some weed and some cheese.
You come home.
They'll let you go. Russia, they got chicken. They don't give a fuck about none of that shit.
You say you was locked up in Clayton County?
Yeah, yeah, that shit.
Too. How long they had you down?
A night, boy. That was a long one, though. It was a long one, boy. It's a long one.
He said a night.
It was a long one.
It was a long one.
It's a long one. It's a long one, bro.
You don't even care.
They had it until breakfast.
It's tough. And I ain't changed out of Clayton County and nothing like that. I had all my same shit.
Oh,
like,
yes.
But nah, Douglas County, I did like a little 30 days or some shit. But
damn.
I always kept
30
on it.
Days matter.
30 days.
Yeah,
30 days legit. 30 days legit. Yeah. I feel 2 weeks. I feel once you change out, once you change clothes, you in that bitch.
Yeah.
Once you go downstairs.
Once you go downstairs. You got over a cough, nigga. You went to jail.
And you feel me? At that point, make your mixtape. Like, cause you done seen some shit at that point.
Yeah, you'd have been in jail at this point, nigga. You had to switch socks.
For sure. For sure.
Mamas.
If you got check a nigga for your socks, like I had check a nigga, I had lost a pair of underwear, they did laundry day and shit. I had to go around, like, looking for my socks and shit.
Damn, bro.
They was misplaced.
You knew anybody in jail?
Oh, I did, bro. I did. But I knew the wrong nigga. He had just got beat up in another pod. I couldn't really fuck with him. Like, yeah, I said.
And that's for the 30 to it?
In the 30. Yeah, I couldn't fuck with him.
You can't be best friends with a nigga that just got beat
up. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
That's terrible.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's
crucial. The one nigga you know.
I ain't play spades with him and shit. Like, I ain't fuck with him at all. Oh, my dog, bro. I'm gonna find
and that nigga beat up too. Like, man, I wonder why Spence ain't fucking with me.
No, nigga, you know what? Nigga. It's all around the pod, nigga. They send the kites.
God damn. Well, shit, a lot of niggas get beat up in jail, though. That don't mean your whole little reputation got to be over, right?
I went in there and started telling jokes, though.
For real?
Yeah, yeah, I was doing my comedy shit in there.
They say you should come with a talent or something.
For sure.
On my mama.
If you a barber, nigga, say that first.
Start off with that.
If you rap, you do comedy.
Niggas, yeah. Just come with your skills
first.
So how
you just walk? You just walk in the gym and be like, all right, what's going on, y'all? How y'all doing? Fuck right next to
give it up for the ladies.
Who all are here on their first offense.
I can't remember how I started, bro. I think we just started by joning and shit. And I used to join the little COs whenever they came.
But you had a little beef jerky at the mic?
Nigga, this shit.
Nigga doing a set in prison with a beef jerky mic.
I projected, bro.
Hitting the nigga kneecap when he worked with the jump work.
Ooh, that's the word right there. That's one of my pet peeves with comedians, too.
Yeah, man. I don't know. I don't know why everybody doing that shit now. Mm-hmm. I love everybody.
They been doing it, though.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Nah, for like 40, 50 years.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I pride myself on not doing too much movement on stage. Like, I don't want to be one of them antic-ass niggas. You know what I'm saying? A lot of niggas got to, you know what I'm saying, juggle and jump through fire and shit like
I'm
that.
I'm one of those comedians, though. I got to act my shit out. I ain't going to lie. I be admiring like people like yourself and Teddy that could just stand right there and just tell a joke and get the whole crowd.
I like that shit, bro. That shit like a preacher, bro. Like you can hold these motherfuckers.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? I ain't never seen you go out. Like, when I seen you host it, it wasn't like on no goofy shit. You know what I'm saying? I just hate that goofy shit, bro.
It's different from goofy and being and acting out. Yeah, exactly.
We was at the show in Oakland. We did the show at, what's the name of y'all? Y'all had a theater in Oakland.
Yeah, Paramount.
Paramount. Okay, the nigga from the radio. I hope he here because I told him that shit was late when he did it. The nigga on the front of the radio, he pulled his pants down. Like,
what?
He was the opener. Yeah, he pulled his pants down.
What?
At the Paramount, yeah. He was the opener. Like, he was the opener. Like,
what was his name, man?
Dark-skinned nigga with dreads.
Dark-skinned nigga with dreads.
Yeah, he was kind of heavy. Yeah, it's not swole. Uh-huh. Swole, I guess, yeah. But he was on the radio. He said he was on the morning station, like the big radio station out there.
These niggas be lying though.
No, no, no. That was already he was on the show.
We got 106 yes. Cameo.
That's what was what okay, what's a nigga ain't no nigga with dreads on there? A dark skinned nigga?
I don't recall.
Lewis know that nigga.
Oh, my mama. I automatically thought you were talking about a nigga. And I'm like, oh, that ain't that nigga. All
right. Nah, this nigga pulled his pants down for sure, though.
Damn. So he pulled his pants down? He had his drawers?
Yeah, he was drawers. He was drawers. He went shin. Like, he went pants to shin.
What?
He went pants to shin for sure. Pants. I said, that's what you got to do to get him going. That nigga said, whatever work. I was like, buddy, each his own, my boy.
I hate that was your first time out, huh?
That wasn't my first time in Oakland. That was my first time meeting him, for sure.
Oh, okay.
It's a horrible first impression.
Yeah, horrible. Don't just call me. Don't go out there roaming no more, because these niggas is embarrassing.
That's what I'm saying. This at the Paramount.
This at not the theater.
This at the theater.
Yeah.
He get to the big show and whip dick out.
Yeah, but Oakland.
He ain't doing that Tommy T.
Yeah, but it's everybody going. The niggas that's opening Tommy T's, he open it everywhere.
Yeah, there were like 2,000 people.
They don't leave the Bay Area. Let me stop. I love everybody.
Some niggas not leaving, bro.
They got professional openers in the Bay.
They ain't gonna come get you, man. They ain't leaving. It's all good, man. Niggas don't leave Atlanta, man. This is my first time, you know what I'm saying, being out doing shows like where I ain't booked or nothing like that, like hitting open mics in another city though. So
how that feel, Juice?
Shit lit, bro. Shit is an experience.
Spreading your wings, getting your name out bro. There.
Cause nigga got dang, I ain't never had no problem getting on stage in Atlanta, but I came out here, but they ain't even wanna let me in the club.
Ooh. Yeah. That's how I felt in New York.
Lewis was down here, come get me. I was
in LA, nigga. You know, it ain't the stage.
Once I found out he from Atlanta, I said, all right. Hey, come on.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Y'all ain't gonna hit my swisher.
I don't smoke.
I smoke woods, bro. That's not a swisher. That's a Dutch. That's a backwood on top of a swisher. And that's just chaotic, nigga.
What's swing that? I was waiting on that.
Yeah, let him try. You talking shit about his butt. Let him try your shit. I fuck
with Jimmy ass. I fuck with Rello one time. I be fucking my cousin.
Yeah, nigga, don't forget where you came from.
I came from Rello.
When I met you, you was smoking them, man.
Niggas get 100,000 followers and just get that.
Yeah.
I don't smoke that little boy shit no more. You know what I'm saying? The little baby blood. That shit. Oh, boy.
I've been on Frontos since 2012, bro.
When I met you, we were smoking that.
Because we was in that strip club in Atlanta.
Yeah, that's what we do. That's how we get down.
You ain't got no fucking frontos. You can't ask for no grabbly from a stripper.
Yeah, it's over.
The bathroom man probably had that shit, though.
No, they don't. None of them did.
It's a good blunt, though. I like that.
They didn't
he want to keep that motherfucker.
Right. That's a good
blunt. Hey, look.
Do me one of these. Do me
one like this.
Yeah, do me that. You can take my weed out of that and put some of yours in there.
Stop.
And go there.
That's hella funny.
We call that a mixtape in the city. Yeah, we just mix that weed up.
Oh, my mama.
Or some put with.
Let me get you a little Sonny Blow pre-roll. You understand me? Yeah, man. It get you right.
Doing it what it's supposed to do. I ain't said it. Don't pass out.
We got to flute this motherfucker.
All right. We been through a lot.
Tell us about the difference between Atlanta comedy scene and your experiences out here in California.
I'm gonna say the experience was different for me, because it's like when you go to another city.
Oh, he double hitting that motherfucker. He loving Cali.
That's the difference. Talk about weed, nephew.
That's the difference. When you don't get no stage time out here, you can step your ass outside and smoke. That's the difference. But God dang. Nigga, y'all got 1,000 comedians, just like we got 1,000 comedians. Like, I ain't know y'all had that many. Niggas be like, it's 1,000 comedians in LA, but it's really like 1,000.
It's really more.
It's a lot, bro.
And it be more at certain times of the year. Like, don't try to be a comedian, nigga, after New Year's.
Oh, ooh.
When niggas do that New Year's resolution.
Oh, I'm getting on stage.
Ooh-wee.
I'm getting on stage.
I avoid the club the same way fit bitches avoid the gym.
Wow. Never peep.
Yeah. And all these niggas, hi, my name is Todd. This is my second day here.
A lot of our vets be out too, though.
You have any advice you can give to us?
Like, what you mean, like Rodney Perry, all them, they really
they be outside.
Because every time I go out there, I see that nigga.
They be outside, boy. Like, they be on the road, but during the week, them LeVar Walkers, Big Sean, all them folks. Them folks be.
Shout out to Rodney Perry, too. I just had to get that man.
Yeah, legend.
Great nigga,
sure.
Bro. Great nigga. He took me to Chuckles. This ain't Chuckles. He took me Chuckles in Memphis. Yeah. Rodney a good dude, bro.
The OGs be outside in Hollywood, though. I would say that, right?
You know what's crazy? I felt like the scene used to be thicker back in the day.
For sure.
Like, when it was that schedule, that Monday night, niggas was still is at the improv. But Tuesday night, Comedy Store. Wednesday night, Inside Jokes. Thursday night.
That was just a hell of a run.
That was a... But... For black shit in that light, bro.
Yeah, that was a run, though.
And then the weekends, you got you could dip off between two clubs, the Comedy Union or the J Spot.
Yeah.
We didn't appreciate that shit.
I did. That's what made me get a spot out here.
Dang. Nah, for sure.
I went from, nigga, no comedy club in Oakland and one comedy club in the East Bay to, nigga, it's like, it was like, really, it was like six nights? Yeah. I'm like, oh yeah, I gotta get out. I gotta stay coming out here on my mama.
Before COVID, we probably had like we probably could do like a 6 a week, six
damn,
or seven.
Damn, for real in Atlanta.
Yeah, bro.
I'm talking about like premiere shows too.
For sure, you know Cats Cafe. Yeah, Cats. Uptown was open Thursday through Sunday.
Shout out to Cats Cafe.
Cats Cafe still going. Still like every Tuesday.
I gotta tap
That's where you gonna see all the OGs at. Like they gonna be there.
Yeah, that was the first spot I hit.
Open mic, great open mic, bro. It's gonna be there.
I remember we bumped into each other.
To this nigga in Atlanta.
Yeah, you in Atlanta type shit. Cats Cafe.
You know me all over the place like space, man. And send me.
I'm trying to pass your ass, nigga. You
nah, we was on some player shit, man. Yeah. Right? You know? Yeah, that's for sure. Damn, I didn't know Cats still be popping like that.
Yeah, bro. Cats really only, one of the only ones that's still going. We used to have like Sweet Lounge. SL Lounge, Taboo 2, Cloud 9, all these were like in the same week. Them bitches be going hard.
For real?
Yeah.
And then, but the difference is that the comedians be able to actually get on stage.
Oh, that is the difference. It might you might see like a 25, 30 comedians in one night.
You lying.
It's going to be like a 20. It's going to be a 3-hour show.
Atlanta let everybody get up.
Atlanta let everybody get up.
But
during the
20
week,
people?
You might see a 20.
Bro, I ain't never seen no shit like this. We was at Uptown. Nigga, I was like, okay, so headliner is just the nigga going last.
Slick, but shit.
That ain't no... You ain't no headliner, because this nigga need 10.
These open mics, I'm not, except Uptown and shit, there ain't really no headliner. Like, ain't nobody getting paid. Like, we all just here. We all just deep as fuck.
And that's what's wrong with, I would say, a lot of other places, damn near outside of Atlanta. I don't know no spot, like, ain't no city you could just fuck with it like that. Like,
what?
Oh, you kind of learning. You're getting up. Whether you just started or you a vet, nigga. You
the Bay Area, though, you can't even get up in the Bay Area really nowhere like that. People, it ain't even no open mics in the Bay Area really like that. It's probably like, shit, I don't want to just say one, but I don't know.
I feel like there's some white ones in Frisco.
Oh, yeah, but that's a whole different world.
Shit, nigga, it's our world, nigga. Get in that shit.
Nah, it sound good. It sounds
good.
Hey,
bro. Anybody out there, fuck like these niggas. Go raid their mics, bro.
It ain't nothing like San Francisco. It ain't nowhere.
If you
want
to make it, go to San
world.
Francisco, nigga.
Go raid their mics. Nigga, I done pulled up on a couple mics. And it showed
Francisco?
Out. Yes, nigga.
An open mic.
Yes. On my mama, Lou.
And who was there? Who you
and who was there, yeah.
I don't know, nigga. White people.
Nigga, you can go to open mic
and
in
this
San
was
Francisco.
Years ago. I'm not saying this was, nigga, like last week.
And they be playing politics in San Francisco.
Yeah.
They be trying to act like nigga. I remember I went to the Punchline San
nigga,
Francisco
I,
one
put
time.
It to you this way. I did so good that they wanted to find out a way to pay me next time.
You need to move to San Francisco then. Nigga, you a legend. Because I ain't even heard nobody say no shit like that.
The fuck? I don't know where this was, bro. I just know it was white people and Asian people, and that's all I can remember.
Your ass was probably in Berkeley somewhere, thinking you were in San Francisco.
No, it was Frisco.
Damn, that's crazy. What year was this? When was you in the Bay without tapping in? Fuck is going on?
This was before I knew the niggas in the Bay. I was just going up there willy-nilly. I went up there to do Clusterfest, I believe.
What the fuck is that?
See? Some old white shit.
Oh, okay.
They had a whole festival of comedy, nigga, up there. They don't tell niggas nothing in the Bay.
They don't, bro.
They don't tell niggas nothing. No. Don't just limit that shit
that
to the
year,
Bay.
So they just invited me. I did warm up for my nigga James Davis, Hood Adjacent. And so I think that's what got me invited to Clusterfest.
Oh, okay.
Because the Comedy Central execs was there all week watching me.
Oh, you slid on some Hollywood shit, though.
Yeah.
That's but I'm talking about the bottom.
Yeah.
You the mics is at the bottom, though.
That ain't no trenches.
Yeah, that's not the trenches.
That's white trenches. Trenches.
That's not
no,
trenches.
You went out there as an organized established shit. Artist.
Yeah, that's
what they knew you talking about. I'm talking about I did the coming. Show that I was supposed to do, and then I did some other shit that wasn't had nothing to do with that.
I see what you're saying, but you still was already moving groovy, connected to something.
They knew you was coming.
We talking about a motherfucker from the Bay Area, and you just like, oh, I'm going to San Francisco, so I'm finna hit hella mics. You can. I done mics in San Francisco, but I'm saying it's a different... It's different. You ain't finna... You have to be a different type of individual.
Yeah.
You know?
To hit hella mics.
To hit hella mics is different. Like, certain... I did a show in San Francisco one time.
I just don't want niggas to be discouraged on no shit. Because I hate when niggas be like, oh, it ain't for me.
No. You don't know? Be discouraged, but just don't think it's easy.
It's never easy. Life ain't easy.
Who made it from San Francisco?
Nigga, Bob Saget, nigga. Rest in peace.
For real?
I don't know if he from San Francisco.
I don't know.
Everywhere. I
need some niggas. I need to go to mics where niggas that already made it for me to just be out there doing mics and shit.
Uh-huh.
I need to see some niggas that already made it. Like, cause LA is niggas making it out here. Like, that's why I need to get to LA.
But then you can't get on stage. So it's hella people that's making it. And then
To each his own, though. You know what I'm saying? I got on. You know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
They business. You know what I'm get you an OG. You know what I'm saying? Get you somebody to go help you get on. Or know these niggas. These niggas got they put you on stage. Lewis ain't put me on Monday. You know what I'm saying? I had to call somebody, but shit.
I didn't put you on stage.
I had to pay, but I went. I
for
went
real? I was going to say. Oh, like,
I don't know why they paid
me. Oh, they played you out, man.
Somebody just took that nigga money. Don't nobody pay to get on at the improv.
Nah, oh,
my
man.
Mama.
Nah, but I'm saying for niggas to be out traveling and shit like that, you gotta goddamn have you something going where you from. You can't take over the world until you take over your city. So
I
shit.
Truly believe that.
So shit, once you get on in your city, nigga, it'll be easier for you to move around. They be like, oh, that's the nigga who making noise, you know what I'm saying, in Atlanta or San Francisco or wherever the hell you from.
Facts.
So shit, don't be out here trying to, cause I jumped the gun like that before. I started comedy at like 20, 13, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
I jumped the gun. I went to New York in like 2014, 2015.
Uh-huh.
And just went up there on like a 2 week type shit. Like I'm out here. But I ain't know nobody. I ain't know vets, none of that shit. So I'm out there like trying to get on stage. And I got on a few stages and shit, but you know, niggas was like, well, all you gotta do is go to New York, you gonna make some money.
That's what they tell you.
And right I there. Went out there, well, I was on a burnt mission.
Bro, I made like $20. Like,
shit, you made $200?
20.
Oh, 20. Oh, I was gonna say, nigga, I didn't make no $200.
You made that 20 sound like 200 for sure.
Only reason I made $20 because I did Drew Frazier's show and I see him get paid. He got paid like $2,000-$3,000 and he see me looking sad as fuck.
Yeah.
Nigga pulled off one of the 20s off the ship. Like,
wow.
Get you a drink, young blood. Like, why? I'm not thirsty, bro. Like,
yeah.
Not for no drink, nigga. I was living that cash.
But damn,
yeah, it was
bro.
Cool though. Like I met some niggas, but shit, nigga, when you just starting off, sometimes you don't even know who you need to meet. Like shit, you might be thinking you fucking with the right nigga, and this nigga not having no motion, man. Nothing going on. You
keep
talking
going.
To the wrong. You talking to the wrong nigga. You gonna end up in the wrong circle. And then when you finally meet somebody that you supposed to meet, them folk looking at you like, damn, that
you fucking with those niggas.
The niggas that we don't fuck with. Like nigga, this. It's not it, bro. You in the wrong circle. And the shit I be trying to say is not like high school, but it got so many high school like similarities and shit.
With the
like,
cliques and all the
cliques and shit like that. And nigga don't want to be clicked up, but nigga don't want to be exiled neither. But
yeah,
so you got to move right, nigga. So you got to. And it's bad start to fuck you up too, nigga. You coming the game wrong, nigga. Your name may be fucked up when you go somewhere else, boy.
Yeah,
you got to play it right.
Nah, that's a fact. That's why I keep the. That's why I got the do too much comedy night in Oakland every Friday. You understand me?
Plug open your mic, shit.
Pull up, open mic, cause that's what it's about, bro. Cause motherfuckers be having clicks, and then the new comedians can't get on the scene, and then the people that's trying to fake be gatekeepers in a little local scene don't even be nobody. And if you a new comedian, you don't know. You know, you be like, oh, this nigga.
Or they got stories from the 90s. That's full of L.A. niggas. L.A. niggas love to tell you what they did.
Oh, for real? That's how it was out here?
In the 90s, nigga. And then I had to learn, like, But y'all niggas ain't working today, though.
That what I'm saying. I already done it. Don't even want to talk to a nigga. You been doing this shit 20, 30 years, boy. Nigga, that day. I ain't saying I done passed you, but shit, I ain't seen you having no motion since I done started.
Unless you steady working. Like, I live on the same block as, what's this nigga name? I've seen this nigga my whole life. Shang. You know Shang, the comedian? Uh-huh.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, Shang be working.
Shang be working like a motherfucker.
Shang work his motherfucking ass off. But I've been seeing this man my whole life, and I always knew he was a comedian. But it was, he don't approach it like, here, young nigga, do this. Do what I'm doing. He was like, nigga, look, this is how I'm getting it, nigga. I like to talk about this type of shit. Mm-hmm. And this what the fuck is it? You know, just find what you like to talk about.
Yeah.
And keep working.
And see, that's the advantage of L.A., in Atlanta, because in Oakland, it's the motherfuckers, the OGs. When I came in the game, the OGs, they was, I didn't know them. Like, nobody knew the local comedy scene. So it was like a desert. Like, the Mark Currys, the new Lunels, and all them, they was out here.
Yeah.
So it's like, LA, you ain't looking up to nobody. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You ain't seeing nobody. It's just,
that's why a nigga bunch be of like, I gotta get to LA. That's why a nigga be like, I gotta get to LA.
I gotta get to LA.
I gotta get to LA. Yeah. Our OGs go to LA and shit like that. They be like, Rodney go crazy out here whenever he come down.
Oh, yeah, but see, y'all got legit.
I like Atlanta OGs because, you know what I'm saying? I feel like everybody ain't gonna be like a Kevin Hart or shit like that. Mm-hmm. But Atlanta got some OGs where these niggas been doing this shit 20, 30 years and really making a living out that shit. Like, been doing this shit consistently. No job, just straight. I'm on stage, grind, and making take care of their kids and all this shit. Like, them the OGs I fuck with. Like, they show me, like, okay, nigga, you may not be Kobe, nigga, but you can be a goddamn Gilbert Arenas don't suck, nigga.
Oh, my
mom. Gilbert Arenas don't suck.
He'll
bust your ass, nigga.
Kobe put 60 on Kobe.
You feel me? He put 60 on Gilbert Arenas and bust your ass. Yeah. So it's a lot of OG, like, they're like vets, good, strong vets.
See, I had to come to LA to feel that energy from my OGs, from where I'm from,
because
the Mark Currys, and they out here, so I didn't really know how big Mark Curry was and his influence until I got out here and then seen him around the legends. Well, I see Mar Lawrence walking with Mark Curry.
You know how big of a legend Mark Curry was?
I know he was, but
he was so big, it was just...
No, it's not even that. It's just, you gotta say, I'm 28, Mark Curry 61, so it's like...
Mark Curry's 61.
He a OG, he a real OG. And then Mark Curry got a big family, so he like, he ain't like no like, he Hollywood, but he not. You know what I'm saying? Because
I ain't know what type of nigga that was. That nigga came to Atlanta, bro. I smoked with that man and shit.
That nigga a real nigga.
Real nigga, bro.
I'm going to chop it up with you.
Bro, what?
I seen Mar Lawrence excited to see Mark Curry. Like, Marlon was like, nigga, Mark, man, what's up?
Bruh, and the crazy
part, like, this my youngster, Lewis Bell. Woo-woo. I'm like, damn, so this would have been, this would have been raw if, like, it was hella comedians, like, up there from Oakland, and they come to Oakland, it would be easy opportunity.
Like, it's like your class of people, too. Like, you, them niggas shared probably countless stages on their way up. Like, seeing you.
Yeah,
nigga, and you kicking it with a nigga and being like, nigga, this is my young nigga. That I'm like, what's up, nigga? You like, y'all niggas know each other. Yeah. Like, nigga, fuck, know each other.
What? Besties.
That is crazy though, bro.
A lot of them, bro. Like, I already be saying that shit. Like, how we connect right now? Yeah. Like, I don't plan on stopping no time soon. I don't see y'all niggas stopping no time soon. So when we see each other 10, 15 years, ain't no telling what nigga gonna be at.
Facts.
Ain't no telling niggas somebody fuck around, stumble up on a TV show or a movie or something like that.
Yeah.
Nigga, oh, that's gonna happen. That's like,
guaranteed. Off the dribble.
And I learned that about the game. Somebody gonna win.
Somebody gonna win.
Somebody
and
close
if you stay
win.
Down long enough, though, you're gonna win. Like, you gonna stay, if you stay down and you good, bro, you gonna win, bro. You gonna win. And it's crazy, cause I ain't know what type of nigga that nigga Mark Curry was. Mm-hmm. God dang, I just didn't know. I pulled out that weed and that nigga said, damn, boy, I thought you was a lame ass nigga, boy. I ain't know you smoked weed. Damn, my nigga.
Yeah.
It cool as fuck.
Yeah, nah, that's raw. How you get locked in with Earthquake?
Boy. God, boy, I be saying that first, because it really just, you know how they be like, right place, right time type shit?
Uh-huh.
So I was doing Uptown Comedy Corner on like a Wednesday night. There were probably like 20 people in there. But Young Jock was in there.
Mm-hmm.
And he had pulled me to the side after I got off stage and shit. Was like, I want you to come to Punta Cana and do a show with me out there. This is like 2017. Mm-hmm. And then he was like, "I want you, we got a comedy show we do on this little
resort."
Shout
out to Jock. That's my nigga. Like Jock be lying.
Nah, Jock. Jock certain
shit. This
is Jock outside, man.
This is a certified Jock story, y'all.
Jock outside.
Yeah, young
sure.
Jock fucked up. They better stop acting like he done had a whole world doing this, nigga.
But he had a letter turn.
All in your living room, nigga.
Oh, mama,
but he had a letter turn, bro.
He
had the city going, but Jock had a run. But yeah, this 2017, so he gonna bring me out to Punta Cana. Before they got a little weekend, they do like a little weekend experience. You know what I'm saying? Everybody fly out. They do the little comedy show, concerts, everything like that. They didn't do the comedy show that year in 2017. They canceled it. So he called me back in 2018 and was like, "We having a comedy show. We ain't going to Punta Cana. We going to Montego Bay." Mm-hmm. And he brought me out to Montego Bay in 2018. Mm-hmm. And just so happened, Earthquake was at the resort at the same time. God dang. On the show, Jock was hosting with me and motherfucking Chico Bean.
Oh, okay.
God dang. And I met Chico. Yeah, and I met through his manager, God dang, and then she had linked me up with Quake. But it wouldn't have happened if I had went to Punta Cana the year before, because
it's
at right place, right time.
Everything is everything, man.
He just been fucking with me ever since.
And that show you the connection, that you know, the value of having you know, some type of leverage in your city. You know what I'm saying? It all started from, you know, Jock.
Yeah.
So that's raw.
Mm-hmm.
It all started from my nigga being prepared.
Prepared.
Of course. He went and killed it for 20 niggas.
For 20 niggas.
Not,
you know,
thinking
what
was going to happen.
Because I go in there and
some other shit.
Was it an open mic?
Open mic. That's all I was doing.
That's raw.
That's all I'm doing. Like, I'm outside. It's like Uptown on a Thursday night.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, niggas go to Uptown, then they go to Stiletto's. Right next door, right after.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? The radio station to be in there, it wasn't nobody else. Shotty Shotty was hosting, matter of fact.
Oh, okay.
Shotty Shotty was hosting. Hell yeah. Shout out Shotty Shotty.
That's raw. That's crazy, bro.
Like 20 niggas. Jock had to be like 15 deep. Like, he was the majority of the people.
Wow.
Oh, okay.
And I'm just talking to him like, "Damn, bro, why y'all ain't promote this shit on the radio and shit? Nigga, you ain't want nobody to know you was gonna be here and shit." Like, all that shit. But he was fucking with that shit. And it just been up for nothing.
That's crazy.
Yeah, bro.
That's beautiful.
Yeah.
So, and then you start touring, being on the road with Earthquake.
Mm-hmm.
And how long you been doing that?
This shit since 2018. So
that's raw.
We 4 in. Yeah. We for life.
4PF.
4PF. You feel me? Shout out to them. You know what I'm saying? Back up off on protect little baby at all costs.
Man.
Keep little baby.
Y'all got man.
But I ain't.
Y'all seen little baby pastor Loki press that nigga?
Nah.
Not pressing, but like, you know, I can tell when a nigga trying to get some more offering out of a nigga.
He was trying to get some chicken from little baby.
Y'all see, he blessed.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
He blessed. I need everybody.
Yeah.
He a real LA nigga. You talking about press. That wasn't no press.
Hey, man.
That's a little aggressive, though.
And still, you like, trying to tell the crowd how blessed I am.
You showing attention to it. You showing attention. You bring it to us.
Oh, I see what you saying, Ted.
Well, everybody in here blessed. We all living. What you?
Yeah.
I ain't got nothing better than
you. Want me to give out some blessings. That's what's going on.
Man. Oh, my mama.
You fuck around, get robbed like that other pastor.
No, they laid him down. I think he did. I think he set that up, though.
He might have.
I think he set that up.
What, baby?
No, the other pastor in Brooklyn. You seen him? He got robbed.
He got laid down in the church.
Mid-service?
Nah. Mid-service, yeah. They laid the whole congregation down.
That's what happens when you live stream.
Damn.
You can't cut that live stream off.
Can't cut that live stream. Yeah, nigga posted that. Brett said he got robbed for $1 million. $1 million in jury.
I bet.
Yeah, that's a damn shame.
I bet.
They deserve it.
The pastors be having chicken.
You know what I'm saying?
Him and his wife, they got them both for their jury.
Yeah, they good robbers. They ain't robbed nobody else, like, in the church. I think they just robbed the preacher.
They didn't shoot nobody. They didn't want no offering.
It was real peaceful.
That's cool.
Like, yeah. I think they set through the service. Like, this was at the end.
Yeah.
Like, they
oh, they jacked.
Yeah.
This is going too far now.
Nah, they prayed.
That's beautiful.
Amen. Exactly. It was one report where, like, a nigga was talking beside them doing a prayer. They tapped the little nigga, like, "Hey, man, he praying." Like, type shit like that. Like, they was some real religious niggas. They had a good plan.
They probably asked the Lord, "Nigga, help me."
Yes, and the Lord showed
him. The Lord was like,
"Lord said, you got that 40 on your hip, nigga.
Grab that chain."
He said, "You got the blicky, nigga. I'm telling you what to do. You see it on him.
Bruh.
You see it on him."
That's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my mama.
Yeah, laid him down.
Yeah, these churches getting wild.
Pandemic fucked up the church, but for me.
It really did.
Fucked up church. I ain't seen too many
people's spirits is just they went back.
People watching that shit from home now. That nigga TD going up.
TD going up. TD be so fresh.
TD about the last world will live. That's why he tired.
TD be having that shit on. Bro.
He talking TD like a boy. TD. He talking like Kevin Samuels now.
R.I.P. Kevin, bro.
R.I.P. Kevin Samuels. Damn, off bro. Tops. That's oh my tough. Mama.
That's my nigga, bro.
I fucked with. I was watching that nigga all pandemic.
He how did A take that, man? Y'all was out there. I know y'all was hurt.
Hell yeah, we was hurt. Yeah, nigga.
You ever bumped into him in the A?
Hey, that's where he was. I didn't know he was out there.
He was in Atlanta.
Nigga was just on the computer. That nigga didn't come outside. That nigga was like, Wade on Kim Possible. You know that nigga Wade?
Yeah.
Kim Possible out?
Oh, mama.
Yeah, he was like that. Like, he was never outside. I didn't know he was from Atlanta. He from Atlanta?
Nah, he wasn't from Atlanta.
I think he's from Oklahoma.
Just, yeah, Oklahoma.
Okay, yeah. Damn, bro. Yeah, I didn't know he was in the city. He should have said something.
I think the bitch did it. I think a female killed him.
Man, that nigga ain't been outside in so long. Been dogging all these hoes. He finally got a good one. She put that thing on him.
She put that suplex
she
on
put
him.
That, she, he, if he was in Atlanta, I know what she put on him. I done had it done. Yeah, damn, yeah.
Damn,
girl. The one that make you feel good, he probably couldn't take it. Heart just busted. Everything busted.
And he probably was off 2 honey packs.
Need that honey go crazy in Atlanta. Y'all having the honey out here?
Yeah, but it ain't.
This real honey, though. It's pure.
It's ginseng honey, nigga. Yeah, everybody does.
Yeah, this is pure. We having the pure stuff in Atlanta.
Y'all niggas is really out there
this
facing.
This is this rarest form right here. This is pure.
That's pure.
This is, I can't feel my face. Yeah, I said, this is that honey from Blow.
Wow, y'all doing the most of the honey, nigga. No wonder the Rico's is it, nigga. Niggas got the purest. I can't feel my face, honey, nigga. That
I don't know what that man talking about them Ricos. Free thug. Folks ain't do nothing.
Free YSL, free thug.
Free them folks, man.
Free gunna.
Free the whole Atlanta.
Smile like Shawty, all y'all folks, man. Shit, oh, gunna look so sad in that picture.
He looks sick, bro.
Oh, man. He like, hey, bro, I really just be rapping. Like I
yeah, he's a rapper.
I'm just a rapper, bro.
Sold out dates, and I'm that's all you want to do, nigga.
I took the top off. Oh man, that's how you know this is good. You know, usually backwards fall apart at the end.
Bro, mine don't fall apart, bro.
That's tough.
And usually that comes from a lot of niggas. It's monkeypox out here.
Yeah.
You know.
Is the monkeypox gonna get to the A?
The monkeypox is everywhere, nigga.
Nah, shit don't come to Atlanta.
They ain't in Atlanta.
COVID didn't come to Atlana.
It didn't.
It came.
Slid during the pandemic.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, because it went there. It was the only place in the world. We Wakanda.
Stop it.
We the real Wakanda, bro. This real shit.
I don't think niggas catching Rico cases in Wakanda.
Them niggas gonna beat. They gonna beat that shit. They gonna take two, three years
out of their life, though.
I don't think niggas is stealing niggas' rims.
They can't damn near talk to the judge again until next year.
I've been dying.
Judge say, hey, bitch, I don't want to hear from you niggas till 2023.
We've been writing letters and shit as a community. Like, we gonna get these niggas out.
I'm telling you.
Shit don't move without. Shit done changing. I ain't know how bad it was, though. Like, Thug really fucked me up because I was out there doing the show out there in Oakland. And I was talking like Thug, and they was like, bro, you can't really talk like that. You know what I'm saying?
You can't really talk
what you
like
mean?
Like slime and all that shit. Like, uh-huh. That's how, this is how we talk. Like, we say slack. You know what I'm saying? They was like, bro,
yeah,
you can't
they
just
understand.
Why not, bro? Like the reason the red shoestring is on the right is because there's some shit Thug would do. Like, free my slime. You know what I'm saying?
They was
like, all that wipe your nose shit. They was like, yeah, that'll get you killed out here.
Nav Green taught me. He told me what wipe your nose meant. I didn't know what that shit meant.
I went to Atlanta.
We was doing a slang exchange. You understand me? So I was telling him about all the little lingo. You understand me about the bay and all the shit.
For sure.
Like, we say Boosie. So Boosie mean you lame. Yeah. They ain't got shit to do with Lil Boosie. We love Lil Boosie.
Yeah.
But it's just a term like, nigga, you hella Boosie. Like, oh, that Laker jersey, Boosie.
Yeah.
But that don't make sense if you say that shit in Atlanta. They don't know what the fuck you're talking
about.
You feel me? So now I was like, yeah. So he was like, nigga, wipe a nigga nose. And I'm like, what the fuck is wipe a nigga
take
nose?
Take a nigga off the earth, man.
Yeah. I'm like, oh, I liked that term, though. I'm like, that was raw.
That's why they was doing the emojis
they
and
don't
shit
work,
with
though.
The blow.
Nigga got sinus issues and allergies and shit, nigga. Yeah. I'm going to be at the club
mm-mm.
wiping the wrong nose at the wrong time, nigga.
It's just one finger, though. It's just... So what? I'm wiping the nose.
For the people that don't get it, that's watching this at home.
So oh, yeah.
Wipe a nigga. Wipe. Well, how you say it?
Wipe a nigga nose.
Wipe a nigga nose is basically you get a nigga gone, you know what I'm saying? Get
wipe a nigga nose.com. I ain't know wipe no nose.
You know they doing this the same shit right now in court?
This shit is. This the part I can. This public information. This public information. This public information.
Every rapper saying that shit now. Yeah, so when I was when I be listening to the songs, yeah. I knew what they were talking about because I went out there and got laced up. Yeah. Like, okay, boom. Mm-hmm. You feel me?
Mm-hmm. Like I was out here, I had said to an Oakland nigga, he was like, yeah, this nigga doing such and such. I was like, oh, he having motion. Mm-hmm. He was like, what? I was like, yeah, that nigga, he moving around. He yeah, he on his way yeah, up. Like yeah, he having something motion. Going.
Yeah.
Like y'all was, a nigga said I said some niggas that got into it, a nigga said out here, he was like, oh, they was funking?
Yeah, they funky.
Like, what the fuck is that? I said, I don't like that.
Yeah, funky like, means we got a problem, nigga. We
I took
funky.
That. I took that. That's in the city.
I told a few niggas that.
We funky, nigga. We funky,
nigga. I tried to spread that one in the city. Uh-huh. I'm trying to
see y'all got this P shit from the Bay. That pushing P shit? That's some Bay shit, man. You understand me?
I don't
me?
Know. We been doing P.
No, players is everywhere.
Rocco had a song. He had Power of the P. That was 2011-12.
But Rocco pussy. Really a...
Nah, Power to P. It was everything. Yeah, before that paper, all that pussy, man. It was a whole song
oh,
of P.
Oh, the whole thing? Okay. Whole,
yeah.
Nah, P is one thing. Yeah. It's some player shit, pimping. Player is that.
See,
player.
That's what... And see, Atlanta just takes shit and we got dangerous...
Exactly.
Put more P on
y'all
it.
Y'all be taking shit and then but, make it bigger.
But we make it saucier, though. We make it
nah,
saucier.
Y'all make it more
niggas
universal.
Took shit from, niggas took cap from us, though.
For real?
Niggas took cap from us. For the show. Niggas been saying cap in Atlanta.
I like thought that was Chicago.
They try to say it's Chicago. Chicago ain't
I
Chicago
Texas
is stock.
Niggas saying.
Man, what? Texas is last on everything. It's
oh,
Texas.
We can't get at Texas like that. Nah. Uh-uh,
out of the majors? Out of the majors? Out of New York, Atlanta, LA?
In the Bay. That's what I'm saying.
Whoa.
Y'all took tap in from us too. I was walking in Atlanta, nigga was like, yeah, tap in. I'm like, nigga, you know who you talking to? I'm nigga, I started this barbecue business.
I don't know that. Tap in. We may have borrowed that one.
Y'all borrowed that. That's what I'm saying. Y'all be knowing y'all getting the
game. That from Sweetie though.
No. They got that.
No, I'm saying the new nigga got it from
Sweetie.
We were saying it before that.
This is before the song.
She got it from Quavo.
Yeah.
She got it from Quavo.
No. Quavo probably got it from a nigga that sold some weed to that nigga and told him tap in if you trying to get some weed, nigga.
Quavo ain't gonna be last to get it, but shit, he in the north. So whatever legal he got it from Thug. That's why we kinda froze right now. We don't know what to say right now.
Oh my mama.
Thug gotta get back out. Gotta give us some more pee.
Just know, tap in came from the soil. That's Bay Area. You understand me?
Y'all can have
in
that
this
one. That
shit,
one ain't
man.
That one really ain't a good slime is universal now.
Yeah, y'all shit going crazy.
Slime is universal now.
If y'all saying cap, but I thought Chicago. I ain't
niggas were saying slime when Nickelodeon was hot, nigga. Knock it off.
Yeah, but Nickelodeon was shot in Atlanta.
No, it wasn't. Nickelodeon Studios is right here on Sunset.
That's on Tyler Perry Studios.
No. See, this nigga really sat up here with a straight face like Nickelodeon shot in Atlanta. I used to see Nickelodeon every day, nigga. What the fuck are you talking about? And be in my mind like, damn, they shooting Kid in the Killer there.
Yeah, that ain't the same slime though.
Come on,
slime, bro.
Slack.
Slack.
I'll give y'all slack.
Y'all give slack. Niggas thought Roddy Rich was from Atlanta.
I can see that.
Yeah, but he's
I
not.
Can see that.
Niggas playing with it. Niggas back playing with Roddy Rich. Yeah, but he not.
Y'all can have Roddy. Y'all can have Roddy. That's a good one. Y'all can have Roddy. Roddy ain't dropped nothing about what.
See, what the Atlanta rappers be doing, they be making transactions with Bay niggas, right? And then be, hey, P, I got this, you feel me, for you, woo, woo, tap in. And then they be like, oh, that shit sounded dope. And then they make a song, and then they go up, and then the Bay niggas just got hella chains on, made hella money,
I ain't gonna lie, most of
them niggas
get stolen from the Bay.
On my mama.
In the country?
Yes!
I don't know
before
that.
He told them niggas, I'm from the Sawyer where them rappers be getting their lingo from. On my mama, nigga. What?
That's no disrespect to E-40, but we ain't listening to E-40 in Atlanta.
You yeah. Tripping. Uh-oh. Too short? Too short is the reason why Lil Jon exists.
We listen to Future
he discovered
Thug.
Lil Jon.
This is the Future of Thug.
Who was y'all listening to before them niggas?
That's
before
what I'm saying. Them? Y'all know y'all,
y'all
got
listening
game
to Yin Yang.
Jeezy and Gucci.
Oh, yeah.
For sure.
And Tip.
until and they ain't got shit.
And Yin Yang.
Hey, them
after,
three.
After them niggas spin, yeah, we got. Them three ain't got no party. We party Yin Yang and Young Bloods and that shit. Lil Jon, Eastside Boys, they get some spin.
The crunk shit.
But what we listening to, like what we riding to, is Jeezy, Gucci, Tip.
For sure, and they ain't got shit to do with the Bay.
And Dro. And Drew, and you know, Drew, he ain't the baby sure. Either. Like,
he ain't
shit.
Got shit. Hey, shit doing
Drew, Drew really, like, low key that nigga from
bro,
the.
Bro, he's so
man.
Underrated, bro. Yeah. That nigga's so underrated, bro. That nigga go hard, bro. He had niggas on that polo shit heavy.
Yeah, Drew was saucy. But
he still, nigga, polo still owed saucy. That nigga a check. Polo yeah. Owed that nigga.
Damn.
Hey, man, you need to start your company where, like, you. Charge niggas to like roll their blunts or some shit like that.
Man, niggas, I ain't gonna hold you. Niggas been trying to do that for me for years. Like, I get around certain rap niggas and
you gotta get
rich them. Niggas, and they be like, nigga, you the blunt roller of the night. I'm like, no, nigga.
Yeah, nuh-uh.
I'ma roll my weed.
That's a heavy task, though. It is right. A heavy task. But that's why I say you deserve a check for it. Cause these
when I was broker, though, yeah, nigga, shout out to Cat Williams. I was rolling blunts for that nigga. I ain't gonna hold you. Act like I wasn't. You feel me?
That's a good nigga. That's
Cat
Blunts for
that's, hey, it's Cat. It's Cat nigga.
I roll Cat Blunts.
That nigga used to slap stacks in my hand.
Hey, you talking about?
Fuck
I'm gonna take that one. I'm
oh
take
shit, bro! That's hella funny. Y'all niggas crazy.
Yeah, I would never though. Now,
yeah.
Never.
No, I just had to shout that out. At y'all at home, y'all ain't having these pearls like this, man.
Hey, man, God is good. That's all I'm gonna say.
Hey,
get you something, and then focus on God, and then
God got you rolling like this.
Yeah.
Rolling weed like that?
This nigga ain't special. He's just Californian.
What you mean?
This nigga ain't special. This a backwood. You got this nigga give you all these flowers rolling a backwood.
It's a good
bro, let this nigga show love.
You don't smoke.
You don't smoke, nigga.
You don't know, bro. That's lame, bro. Don't do that.
No, because Teddy always be making my woman roll the blunt when we all together.
That nigga.
But roll this.
Man, that nigga boosted.
That's
because
I don't be liking to roll in the car a lot.
That's what I'm saying. He be lazy with the rolling. Be having motherfuckers roll. Now he trying to get the clout on camera, man.
Man, Teddy, that nigga get boosty when I got dang give you props, bro. That nigga boosty, man.
Man, he's a different right type of nigga, bro.
Hey, you using the right, too. But, you know, keep calling me boosty. I wipe a nigga nose.
That good. Hey,
that's how arguments get started.
You got that.
Pistols get pulled out.
Nah, we just exchange the slang. You understand me?
They got the stacks.
Yeah, man. Popping.
What's
beans.
Up with Cascade skating, man? They still back skating.
They're skating there. We can't.
For real?
Yeah, Sunday.
Mm-hmm. I was thinking about going, but I'm like, that's in the Jets.
It's right there by Popeyes, ain't it?
That's where I stay.
That's where you stay?
Well, nigga, I'm going to call you and then I'm going to
Yeah.
That nigga's that's what I was thinking.
That shit right there.
He want me to stop talking about the area here because that's
No. So the crazy part, Cascade is on MLK, and then I stay on Cascade. I don't know why it's called Cascade because it's on MLK. But like, it's age of 9, I'm age of 7.
Was y'all juice that T.I. made a movie about Cascades and y'all watched
that
ATL?
Shit lit. ATL top 5 movie.
So bruh. Y'all fucked with ATL in Atlanta.
What? Nunu? Mm-hmm. What? Yeah. Teddy? That shit hard as fuck.
And guess where Nunu from?
I understand what you're saying.
Hey, man.
Y'all got that.
Blessings the Lord. Love the queen.
Don't leave me hanging. Y'all got that.
For sure. Nah, but nigga, ATL, bro, we watch that shit out here every day, bro.
That shit was like,
I think that's the last great collective black movie that we can all just be like, yeah, that was the one.
That shit is a classic, bro. That shit is a classic.
Like, niggas can't even agree on Black Panther 100%.
Now we ain't gonna play out Ryan Coogler. You know where he from, right?
He from the town.
For sure. Ryan Coogler. We got the niggas,
but they
man.
Shot the movie in Atlanta.
Oh.
That's why we call it Wakanda. They shot at Tyler Perry Studio.
Oh.
Is Tyler Perry from Atlanta, though?
Nah, he from
New Orleans or some shit, right?
I don't know where he from.
Yeah, I think so.
That nigga is creative.
But he used to sleep in his car, though, in Atlanta, so I think that's why y'all claim him.
Oh, we'll definitely claim
him. Yeah, y'all gotta claim him. I seen it for the first time. His exit off the freeway.
That shit big.
That shit raw.
That shit big. Like, he got his own zip code.
He got a zip code?
Bro, Tyler Perry shit. The exit is named after him. Like, they changed the exit name. It was like, I think it was East Point or something like that.
Yeah, I seen
that it. That shit say Tyler Perry. Exit 44, Tyler Perry.
He bought an old Confederate base and shoots nothing but black projects on that.
That shit hard, bro. That shit big.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
And then, I know y'all just seen his house he built.
Yeah, that seen shit, that.
Monstrosity. monstrosity of a house.
When you get that much money, you feel like you're gonna need all that shit?
If I got that much money, Tyler Perry money, I mean, why not? I can't take this shit.
Cause low-key, you gotta spend, try to spend some of it, nigga. Like,
I can't take this shit with me.
Yeah, for real. So
I'm gonna be like Rick Ross. I'm gonna be buying cows and shit. Like,
bought a cow.
I thought that shit was cool.
I don't know what I'd do if I had like Tyler Perry type cheese.
Oh man,
I'd be the same nigga. Not like the same person. Of course, I was there as a person. There's no way you can do it. I'm not saying it like that. Y'all taking it out of context.
I don't think I eat chicken no more. Like, everything changed.
What would you eat? Penguin?
Nah, a lot of alligator, for sure.
Alligator is good.
A lot of gator.
Fried alligator?
Daily.
That shit go.
Gator omelets.
You ain't had no gator?
Yeah, I've had gator.
And then I do like...
I ain't never had a nigga talk about he gonna replace his whole for sure. menu with gator.
Gator and salmon. Shrimp, shit like that. Lobster, crab, seafood.
I see what you're saying.
Seafood. Exquisite, though.
Nah, but I forever eat chicken, though. Chicken hella good.
If I get too much money, I don't really need no more bird.
I feel you.
Yeah. Man,
put Prozac in chicken.
I do them trips.
I think that's why niggas is crazy.
They about to take that shit out of out of Popeye's chicken next year?
What?
Oh, they about to take that little seasoning out that they been using.
What
Popeye
finna take out?
Man,
oh, I got you. See how niggas is just alert. Nah, everything was going fine.
Yeah, hold on. They
got nuggets?
Nah, this for real. They about to take it out. They say they're taking it out in 2023. They say it's going to have a whole different taste.
Popeye's is him. Oh, damn, that shit hell out. Popeye's him, though, for sure.
I'm looking it up. Bro.
That's another slang I feel like the world finna steal in a minute.
What?
Him. Like, that's him.
We been saying that's him.
Oh, here y'all go.
It's him. We say that for the pack. Like, when we hit the pack, like, that's him.
Yeah.
That's the one. That's the
one. How long y'all been saying that shit?
We been saying him for a minute. Like, I ain't gonna cap you. We had him.
Yeah, we had him, heem.
We made heem something too, that.
Heem?
That's him.
For real?
Yeah.
All right, man. We need
to have a choir rehearsal that
Yeah, that shit hella loud. Oh, my mama. Hey, can they hear that? No? All right, cool. Yeah, it's some
I
niggas.
I feel like they can. Put a comment, nigga, if you hear. Busted on the beat.
I don't know who that is. That shit hella loud. They loaded.
I mean, that I guess that's what it is. And that's the end of the Cali Kickback,
yeah,
y'all.
Yeah, this shit might be over.
We just got a little theme song.
Before we get out of here, bro, it's monosodium glutamate. That's what they taking out the Popeye's chicken in 2023. So that's their little seasoning shit. They taking it out.
What? See? They gonna fuck around, fall off taking that seasoning
out.
You
know what I'm saying?
But that sounds like it need to be taken out, though.
It sound deadly.
That sound hella like extra salt.
We still here, and I've been eating that my whole life. All of us have. We still here.
I'll eat KFC, though. They got no fucked up chickens.
KFC fell off. They used to be gone when I was little.
But they got the chickens KFC with those six legs and shit.
No?
They got the chickens with the... Y'all don't be on the internet.
What?
Yeah, they got them chickens with the six legs at their farm.
Nice.
They don't be having no beaks and no feathers and shit when they be born and shit.
Mm-mm.
Like, they be making their chickens and shit. Like, dead ass.
You lying.
I heard
you seen
they
it on
feed
the
their chickens to their legs break.
Nah,
that's what I heard.
I need to pull up the KFC chickens.
Yeah.
Nah, you good.
KFC chickens.
You good. Just pass the blunt. You ain't got nothing.
He love that blunt. You want me to show you the chickens? You want me to show you the chickens? It's like a 20-minute video.
Nah, you good.
Video about 20 minutes. Check out the chickens.
Man, hell no.
Read up on this real quick.
Oh, my mama. Oh, shit. Y'all finna fuck around and get me contact high. I ain't been contact high in a minute, though. I'm cool.
That shit smoking.
That's it, though. That's the end of the episode.
Damn near. Them niggas throw a whole vibe off.
All right, man. We'll see y'all,
this
man.
This nigga trying to end the episode hella awkward. All right, man. We gone.
Because it's like you nutted, and it's just like I'm just sitting here
I'm
looking at the bitch in the eye. Like,
I'm ready to go.
Like it's all right. So check it out, man. It's a Cali Kickback. My dog Spencer Neal that slid through. You understand me?
Follow me.
Legend in the making. Drop your drop all your ads.
I am Spencer Neal, man. On Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all that good shit, man. Hey, I'm streaming too on 2K. Yeah, I
mean, talk that shit.
Hey, yeah. Come watch in. Sure. Yeah, come tap in.
You look like you raw in 2K with that jersey.
I do so. You got 2K. Got to play the
24 outfit on.
Come
boy.
On, man. I got to play Homage to Color, man. That was my favorite.
Any nigga
play.
That got the jersey with the braids raw in 2K. Come on, and man. Hoop real life. You know how to hoop in real life?
I play Station. You know what I'm saying? So,
see?
What the fuck is that?
PlayStation.
I'm like, man, what that say?
You was missed the hard shit.
Hey, man. It's the Cali Kickback, man. Stay tapped in with us. You understand me? Teddy Ray, Louis Belt, we gone.
What's up?